Hello, this is Adriana from Tasty Pastry Kitchen, and today we're going to do a step-by-step tutorial on making letter cakes. I even have some free templates that you can print out from my website, so let's just go ahead and jump right in. Okay, so if you need the paper templates to make this cake, go ahead and head on over to my blog, Tasty Pastry Kitchen, and go to the recipes page and look for the post that says how to make letter cakes and cream tarts with paper templates. I'll also list this down in the description box below, so you can just go through that link. So click on here, and this is the post that should have all of the PDFs for every single letter. When you click on a letter, let's say we're doing A for this cake, it'll open up a new tab, and what you can do is print directly from this tab if you're in Chrome, or you can download and save this for later. You just need a PDF reader to open this up and print from. This prints on a standard size 8.5 by 11 sheet of paper, so you don't need any sort of special paper to print it, which actually works out really well for a cake board or a platter that's at least 10 by 14. So if you're just doing one cake, you can place this on a 10 by 14 cake board. If you want to do two initials, you can put this on a 19 by 13 cake board. And I have all that information here on my post if you're interested about the sizing and what kind of cake boards and cake drums that I use. Okay, so go ahead and print those out. So you can print out whatever letter you need to make, and they will all fit on these cake boards. And then let's head on over to the kitchen and make these letter cakes. So here's the half sheet of golden butter cake that I made the other day and put in the freezer. And I will link to that video up in the corner of this one. But this one was left out a little bit longer than I would have liked, so you can see that it's kind of still bendy. You want to make sure when doing this project that your cakes are pretty much frozen. It's going to be quite difficult to manipulate this cake when it's cut, when it's kind of soft like this. So I would say, unless you are a very advanced cake decorator, make sure that your cake is pretty much frozen solid. So the first thing I like to do is lay on a large piece of parchment, because that's going to act as a barrier when I'm doing the cutting. And then I place a large cutting board or platter on top of that, and then completely unwrap the cake. And this is going to serve as your surface for cutting and preparing the cake before you move it onto the cake board. Okay, so one half sheet cake using my templates will give you two layers of cake. So there's like that carpentry saying, right? Measure twice, cut once. And so I always take my template and kind of move it around on the cake and figure out how I'm gonna cut it before I actually do the cutting. So for this letter A, it just kind of worked out for me to give me a little more wiggle room to flip it over upside down and then cut it on the other side. So you can use the template and then just cut the cake according to the shape. And I just use a small paring knife to do this. The more frozen your cake is, the easier this will be, and you'll get slightly cleaner edges this way. The way that I like to do this too is to cut both letters at once and then remove all of the negative space or all the cake that you're not going to use. And then you can place that in a plastic bag or some Tupperware and use it for cakesicles or cake pops or like little trifles. And the reason that we put this on parchment is because we don't want it to stick to the surface that we're cutting on, but it also kind of serves as a way to mobilize the cake. So if you're having trouble cutting the cake because it's too soft or you need to firm it up, you can just slide this parchment paper onto a baking sheet and put it back in the freezer. Once you're done cutting, go ahead and get out your platter or your cake board. And like I said, I was working with this cake that was just way too soft, but I was in a rush when I was making this cake. So it's a little bit more soft than it should be for you. If you have this thing frozen, it should be something that's really easy to lift and transport onto the cake board. But you can use like a large spatula if it helps you. This is actually one of my favorite spatulas, which is a fish spatula. I use it all the time for baking, but you can use it to lift the cake up and place it. Try to place it kind of center in the cake board, because you're not going to be able to move it once we start decorating. And then I kind of go around and tidy the cake up, because remember, this is kind of like a naked cake. There's not going to be any frosting around the sides and everything like that. So you just want to make sure everything looks kind of sharp and even and like no big crumbs sticking out. Okay, stick that top layer of cake back in the freezer so it remains firm, and let's get to decorating the inside of the cake. Okay, so for the filling type, you can use lots of things, including buttercream or different types of cream. I'm using a diplomat cream here because this cake is kind of inspired by a fraisier cake. which is a pastry that has sponge cake and strawberries and pastry cream. I just like diplomat cream, which is just pastry cream with a little bit of whipped cream and gelatin added, because it adds like a lightness to it, because sometimes I feel that pastry cream is very heavy if that's all that you're eating. So one of the key elements of this cake is the ability to see kind of the inside of the cake through the side. And so to get this look, what you're going to need is a piping bag, and you can put a round tip nozzle like I have here, or you can just cut off the edge of the bag, just making sure that you cut straight across so it gives you a perfect line, and then therefore will give you perfect circles. To get these circles, all you have to do is about a couple centimeters above where you're trying to pipe the cream, just push out a large amount of cream, kind of push the nozzle down and then rise up really quickly, and that will give you that kind of circular shape. And then I piped a really small amount of diplomat cream along the interiors and filled with some diced strawberries. Because the frisier cake traditionally has huge chunks of strawberries along the perimeter, and that really wouldn't allow me to stack this cake because of the stability issues, I just went ahead and filled the interior of the cake with it so that when you sliced it, you could kind of get more strawberries on the inside. This step is totally optional. If you were just to use like Swiss meringue buttercream, you could just pipe straight up Swiss meringue buttercream all along the interior and it would be absolutely delicious. I just like adding fruit to pastry cream desserts because it kind of breaks up the sweetness with the acid. Okay, so now we're gonna put the top layer of the cake on, which hopefully your cake should be frozen unlike mine. So you can kind of see mine's tearing a little bit on the sides, but that's totally cool because we can cover up things in cake decorating and most of the time people don't notice. See, once I put that layer on and then kind of maneuver the cake, you can hardly tell, right? All right, so now we are going to pipe the top. So for my topping, I'm just using some freshly whipped cream, because that's traditionally what's served with the frisier cake. And same method. So we're gonna go around the entire top of the cake, making these little kisses all along the top. Now to put the final touches on your letter cake, I've seen several really cute techniques ranging from candies to macarons to sprinkles. I like fruit, so I'm just gonna decorate mine with some fresh strawberries, as well as some fresh lemon thyme from my garden to add a bit of greenery. And then I have these really cute Kalabaut strawberry crisp pearls, and they just are these like little crispy bits of chocolate that look like sprinkles, but they're just kind of like little balls, and they just add little pops of color. Here we have it. This is the finished letter cake that is inspired by a frisier cake. And if you like this video, go ahead and subscribe to my channel. I try to post weekly in-depth baking tutorials. This complete recipe, along with the templates, are available on my blog, Tasty Pastry Kitchen. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again soon.